Do you dream of letting ChatGPT roam the net? I'm Theo from Apify, and today I'm going to show you how to do just that with GPT Scraper. GPT Scraper is a new tool in Apify Store that lets you extract data from any website and feed it into ChatGPT via the OpenAI API. GPT Scraper costs less than a cent per processed page. This includes the cost of the OpenAI API. A free Apify account gives you $5 of platform credit each month. That means you can scrape up to 555 pages for free. You'll need to sign up for a free account to follow this tutorial. So if you don't have one yet, click on the link in the description to quickly set up an account, and let's get started. Now that you have an account, let's go to GPT Scraper on Apify Store and click the Try Actor button. This will take you to Apify Console, which is your dashboard to configure the scraper. I'm going to show you three quick examples of how to use GPT Scraper. One sample use of GPT Scraper is to get ChatGPT to summarize reviews. For this example, we'll copy and paste the IMDb page for reviews of John Wick 4 in the Start URL field. And we'll ask ChatGPT to analyze the reviews and summarize a consensus. To do that, we'll write in the instructions for ChatGPT field, analyze all user reviews for this movie, and summarize the consensus. Now we'll simply click Start, and the scraper will begin the run. Let's just wait for the status to change from running to succeeded. Now it's done, we have this output. For our second example, we'll get ChatGPT to extract keywords from a blog post. We'll copy the URL for the article on scraping Amazon product data on the Apify blog and paste it into the Start URL field. Our prompt for GPT will be, extract keywords from this blog post. Again, we click Start. When the run is finished, we get this output. For our final example, we'll get ChatGPT to find contact details on a web page. In this case, we'll insert the contact page of the Apify website in the Start URL field. We'll insert a prompt, please find contact details on this page and return them as JSON. There will be attributes, company email, company web, GitHub URL, Twitter URL, VAT ID, business ID, and bank account number. When the scraper finishes its run, we get this result. I've only shown you how to use the Start URL and instruction fields, but there are also more advanced options you can use. For example, you can use the CSS selectors to limit the content scraped from web pages. Let's say you want GPT to read blog posts from the Apify website and summarize them in one paragraph, but you only want to extract articles and ignore all the navigation elements and other sidebar content. You can simply add the relevant div to the content selector field. You can also use glob patterns for finer control over which links to enqueue. The glob patterns field specifies which types of URLs found by the link selector should be added to the request queue. A glob pattern is simply a string with wildcard characters. For example, this glob pattern will match all the following URLs. Before I go, let me show you a couple of other hidden features you might find helpful. You can skip pages from the output by asking GPT to answer with skip this page. For example, summarize this page into three sentences. If the page is about proxies, answer with skip this page. You can also instruct GPT to answer with JSON, and the scraper under the hood will parse this JSON and store it as a structured answer. For example, find all links on this page and return them as JSON. There will be one attribute links containing an array of URLs. That's all I'm going to show you today, but that's just the tip of the iceberg. So please do go ahead and experiment with GPT Scraper to find out what else it's capable of. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe and click that bell for future content. That's all for now. So long, and thanks for all the likes.